got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite when you're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth, and happy Friday evening. It's about 10 p.m. and I'm just checking emails. And I wanted to get this out to you immediately because this is a big deal for this country, and all of you need to put some time and thought into this if you give two shits about the economy, the environment, freedom of choice, etc., etc. Because as you see from the headline here, we're at normal.org, U.S. Senate considers hemp farming bill for the first time. Senate lawmakers have introduced legislation in Congress to allow for the commercial production of industrial hemp. It's the first time in modern history that such legislation has ever been before members of the United States Senate. I'm going to link you to this, and you can read on. I'm just going to give you an overview. And I want to bring you here from Normal. You'll get a link right here at votehemp.com, which I'm over there now. And I'll link you to this as well. But I want you to concentrate for a minute here on some of these facts about hemp. This will quickly inform you. Hemp is among the oldest industries on the planet, going back more than 10,000 years to the beginnings of pottery. Presidents Washington and Jefferson both grew hemp. Americans were legally bound to grow hemp during the colonial era. Carbohydrates from hemp can be processed into a wide range of biomass energy sources. Grows well without herbicides, fungicides, or pesticides, which is a big deal. Hemp produces more pulp per acre than timber. It's actually 4.1 to 1. Eco-friendly hemp can replace most toxic petrochemical products. Research being done to use hemp in manufacturing. Sorry, I missed it. Hemp is one of the most perfect sources for human nutrition in all of nature. That's a big one. We all need to be more healthy. The United States is the only industrialized nation to prohibit it. Make the most you can of the Indian hemp seed and sow it everywhere. Hemp is among the oldest industry on the planet, going back more than 10,000 years. Okay, so, folks, this can be a major shift in this country. First of all, let me remind you that we don't fucking make anything here anymore. It's all made in China, Taiwan, where the hell. Everybody else is working. Everyone else is being creative. We're not making a goddamn thing. We've cut down all of our trees. We're polluting the hell out of everything. We got farmers that can't get paid enough from their normal crops, so they've shut down their farms. They're losing their farms. There's just a million and one reasons to legalize hemp. First of all, it's a damn plant. Should we need to go any farther than that? But for those of you that don't make any major decisions and won't get off your asses to make any changes unless money is involved, there's a lot of money involved, billions of dollars, and that's exactly why it's been kept illegal, because if we were producing hemp everywhere we could in this country, we wouldn't be buying as much fuel, folks, paints, just so many things. The list goes on and on. I can't even get into how many products we could actually start making. Do you know how many families we could put back to work? The family farm could actually be productive again in growing hemp and maybe turning that hemp into their own clothing, into their own fuel, lamp oils, rubs, whatever the heck they want to do. Maybe they just want to grow it for the seed and be healthy and eat the seed. I don't know what they want to do, but they would have that opportunity. Yeah, Big Pharma's going to lose money. Yeah, the oil company's going to lose money. Yeah, the paper company's going to lose money. But all those people are making this country toxic. And all those farmers are sitting there with dormant land, not doing anything. We have to take action on this. This isn't a drug issue. This is an economical, sensible commodity that our forefathers told us we should be doing. And then we made it illegal. And here we are, tens of thousands of dollars per person in debt in a plant being made illegal that could probably turn this economy around in 3 to 5 years if major changes were made in the legislation. So we need to do that, And I'm going to link you to normal.org. You should be getting email updates from them to inform yourself on the hemp and marijuana issue anyway. Even if you're not a smoker, you should at least be educating yourself and know where this goes and at least back people's freedom of choice. And also, I've gone over here to the Action Alert where we're going to send Obama an email. You know, we need to do this. And I want to encourage you to use this site, votehemp.com, that I'll link you to contact your local senators and representatives and make sure that they understand that this is something that we have to do. And again, we have to hold these people accountable. They're stealing our money. They're stealing our money. This is a plant. We should be allowed to grow it. We should be able to use it and turn our economy around. And this is an injustice by keeping it illegal. So please, take a minute. I'm going to show you, as always, that I don't ask you to do anything that I haven't already done myself. So this is all filled out, my name, address, phone number, all that. I'm going to show you that the message has been sent. If millions of us do this, well, then that's what we need to do. And while you're over here, post it to your Facebook, okay? Do whatever you can do. Share this information, spread it around, inform yourself, get off your ass, take action, and give people something to look forward to. Anyway, much love, many thanks, happy Friday, have a safe weekend, and I'll probably see you again before it's over with.